Have you ever wished it was just a little bit easier to manage your Outlook account? Well, today we're going to look at how Copilot in Outlook can make managing everyday tasks just a little bit easier, faster, and less overwhelming. With Copilot Chat or Copilot for Microsoft 365, anybody can draft emails, look for key information, and get a bit of help organizing their inbox without needing advanced technical skills. So whether you're new to Outlook or you just want to see what's possible, we're about to go over a few simple things that can make a big difference. Let's start with Copilot Chat. From the home ribbon, if you go to the right-hand side of the screen, you'll see the Copilot button. This allows you to get quick access to Copilot features in Outlook without going to another web page. A pane will open on the right side of the screen. If we go all the way to the bottom of the pane, you will see a note telling you that you are using Copilot with standard access. This means the free version that's included with a Microsoft 365 business or enterprise license, basically your work account. In the chat pane, you can ask Copilot to help you with some basic Outlook tasks like drafting an out-of-office message or analyzing text to get suggestions for improvement. The Analyze Text option is one that I see people use a lot. In the standard version of Copilot, you must paste the text into the prompt box. I do want to point out that anything you ask Copilot while using your work account is protected by Microsoft Data Protection. This means the information is not shared with the public models. It stays within your company's security container. The other place that we will see a Copilot feature is the Summarize button at the top of an email. So let's look at an example. I just copied and pasted a bunch of information into an email. It's long and poorly formatted. This is a message that nobody wants to read, but it might have important information. So let's ask Copilot to summarize it for us. The AI will scan the text and come up with some bullet points. The response will appear in the chat pane. Now, in this example, Adele is giving an update on the Your 365 Advisor community. While reading the summary, I noticed that the free resources are tied to a participation point system. I would like to know more about that, so we're going to ask Copilot to help us draft a reply to this email. When we scroll down to the bottom of the summary, you will see some suggested follow-up prompts. You can go with the generic draft a response, but the more details you add to the prompt, the better the result will be. So I added a bit of context to say I want to ask a question about how to get points towards level unlocks. When I click the enter button, Copilot took a few moments and produced an email in the chat pane. This is pretty good, but you can refine the response by continuing to chat with the AI. As with any AI tools, you are not likely to get the perfect response with just one prompt. The analogy I've heard for this is talking to Copilot is like talking to a human assistant. The more instructions you give the assistant, the better their work product will be, and AI is no different. Now, for the sake of speeding up the video, I'm going to copy the original response and then modify it myself. Notice the toolbar below the response. The first button will copy the related response to your clipboard. Now I'm going to go to Adele's email and click the reply button and paste in the message. The response included a subject line as if I were starting a new email chain. In this case, I'm going to reply to the original email so I don't need the subject line. Then I'm going to remove best regards at the bottom. This is just something I wouldn't say, and I already have a signature block. I also think that each question should be a separate paragraph, so I'm going to quickly make that change. Now remember, you could have used Copilot prompts to make these changes, but I wanted to start simple. Now that we're done making the updates, click Send. Now let's switch to an email account that has the Microsoft 365 Premium license. You will still find the Copilot option from the home ribbon on the right-hand side of the screen. When we scroll down to the bottom of the pane, it says you have Premium Copilot features enabled. One of the key differences with the Premium feature is that you can tell Copilot to only look at your business data when creating responses. like the free version, anything shared with Copilot while using a work account is secured with the Microsoft Enterprise Data Protection. Now, right away, you can see some differences in the chat pane. The suggestion prompts are geared toward analyzing your inbox and helping you find information you might need, such as what's new in my inbox. When I select that prompt, notice that it says, look at the last 10 emails, show dates, pull out quotes, etc. If I ran this prompt, it would provide a much more detailed response than the generic responses we got with the free Copilot. Now let's look at some differences when summarizing an email. The option says Summary by Copilot instead of Summarize. When you click the box, the summary is generated just above the original email instead of in the chat pane. Once it's done, you can refine the results by clicking Ask Copilot. This will open the chat pane if it's not already open. Copilot knows to reference the selected email, and then we can add prompts to refine the results, such as asking for a more detailed summary. Now that that's done, we can see that this new summary is longer, broken into sections, and the sections have bullet points, and it's a lot easier to read than the original poorly formatted email. Let's say we have the same follow-up question about how to unlock the free resources. We can click Reply and draft a response directly into the email instead of drafting it in the chat pane, then copying and pasting it. This simplifies and reduces the friction in the process. In the prompt box, you can choose one of the samples or write your own prompt. Before writing our own prompt, let's scroll down and choose Customize Draft under Options. This will open the Outlook Settings dialog box and take you to the Draft Instructions section. This is where you can tell Copilot about how you write. Include things such as tone, the length of the email, greeting, formatting, etc. In this example, I told Copilot that I tend to use a professional but friendly tone. I want it to provide as many details as necessary without being wordy and to use bullet points to make the response easier to read. Now you'll notice that Copilot doesn't always get it exactly right, so you may have to refine your instructions over time. However, the customized instructions will make the response feel more like it's coming from you and less like it's coming from a robot. Now I'm ready to write my own prompt and ask for more details about how to get participation points. As you can see, the response was inserted into the body of the email as a preview. You can continue to refine the response, delete it, or select Keep It. I will select Keep It to start with this version of the draft. Now I can still ask Copilot for additional changes by hovering the mouse next to the text and clicking the tiny Copilot icon. This time I will ask for each question to be a separate paragraph. A preview of the new response shows up in the Copilot box. We can replace, insert below, or discard. For this example, I will insert below so that I can compare the two versions. There are some little differences, so this is why I like to come in and edit for myself and decide what part of the different versions I want to keep before sending the reply. Now, let's create a new message and have Copilot help us draft it. From the body of the message, click on the little Copilot icon or use the hotkey Alt plus I. I'm going to paste in a prompt with details about the new color coding system used in the classroom. The response is okay, but Copilot didn't recognize my instructions to not use asterisks, and there are dashes instead of bullet points. So I'm going to add another prompt. The preview of this looks much better, though I still think that Copilot doesn't fully understand that bullets should be indented as a style, but that's an easy update for me to make. We can continue adding additional prompts until the message feels just right. So for example, I could change the tone of the message. I typically write in a much more casual tone, but this one needs to be more formal. Copilot can do a lot more in Outlook, but for today, this is enough to help you get started and become familiar with some of the basic options. But I encourage you to play with this feature and see what changes you would ask for based on your workflow and business practices. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.